think I can make your life less painful when it comes to tuning vocals in Pro Tools. Let's find out. Hello and welcome. My name is Malcolm Owen-Flood, and today I'm going to tell you how you can speed up your Melodyne workflow inside of Pro Tools with one simple hack. You know, because we waste enough time as Pro Tools users with prehistoric boot times, iLock activation errors, session loading, iLock activation errors, slower than real-time offline bounces,
iLock activations,
and of course, your session quitting unexpectedly. Yet here we are. You and I, we stick around on Pro Tools because we love to love it and we love to hate it. So click subscribe below and then let's jump in and see if we can speed up this Melodyne workflow a little bit for you. So until recently, people using Melodyne in Pro Tools would have to insert the plugin on the first channel of their DAW and then literally wait in real time as it listened through the audio to scan it into the plugin. From there, you'd be able to manipulate it. But if you had to do this on multiple tracks, could take a lot of time. Yes, you could batch things together and enable, but it was just a huge process. Not very fun, takes you out of it. It's not the type of creative work we had in mind when we wanted to be musicians. However, there is one simple trick that speeds up this data importing process. But first, one quick note. Pro Tools has recently released a new version, Pro Tools 2022.10, which has ARA integration, which essentially removes the need for this whole hack entirely and that whole process I just described. So you can go get that. But if you watch my other video, you will learn that there are some costs with that update. It's not flawless. So if you wanted to stay on your previous version of Pro Tools, or maybe you just don't think upgrading is worth the cost, this hack is for you. And one more warning, this hack is actually incredibly obvious. I'm sure some of you have already figured it out yourself, but I have shared it with some of my colleagues and they didn't know it. So I figure it's worth sharing. Okay, let's jump into it. All right, we've got our session open in front of us and it is really this simple. Step one, insert Melodyne on the track you want to tune. This now shows an empty Melodyne panel inside of Pro Tools. So we have to get the data inside of it, which brings us to step two. We will enable the transfer option inside of the Melodyne window. If the transfer icon is red, that means you've got it enabled. Typically, this is where you would click play and let it scan the audio into the plugin, like so. It will then show us the imported pitch data inside of the Melodyne window. But doing that across the entire song is kind of time consuming, especially if you have to do it across multiple tracks over the course of the project. So how do you make this happen faster? Well, that brings us to the third and final step in this process. But first, I want to tell you that this video is brought to you by the Self-Recordind Band Academy and Podcast. If you are a DIY recording musician or band, you absolutely have to check this out. Head to the link in the description and it'll take you to a free one-on-one coaching call that you can schedule with Benedict Hine, the owner and founder of the Self-Recordind Band. In addition, do check out the Self-Recordind Band podcast. It's available on pretty well any podcasting app that I know of. I've been a co-host since the very beginning and every week we talk about how you can better your recordings DIY style and get a truly professional result. All right, back to that third and final step. How do you make this faster? It's really as simple as this. Instead of clicking play to load the data in real time, you're just going to freeze the track instead. Let me show you. We'll make a new Melodyne insert here. We'll enable transfer, and then we will right click and then commit up to this insert. Now this is important because you might not want to commit all the plugins you have on that channel necessarily. So if you just put Melodyne as the first insert on that channel and then only commit to that plugin, you'll only render the tuning onto that track. So in this instance on my computer, this is rendering at least 4 times faster than real time, which is a huge time saver. So as mentioned, the new version of Pro Tools just lets me right click a track and select Melodyne, and that process will happen automatically and actually much quicker than what I just showed you. But if you don't have the newest version of Pro Tools, this is the fix for you. I hope this helps you speed up your workflow. And that's about it. You should be able to unfreeze your track and that data should now be reflected in the session. It speeds it up in that you don't have to do it in real time. It will happen as you track freeze, which is a huge time saver in my experience. Mileage may vary depending on your computer, but overall, I think most people would benefit from this. It's simple, but the best things in life usually are. As mentioned, Pro Tools does have a new update out, which essentially eliminates the need to do any of this, but there are some hidden costs, so please do check out my other video on that topic. And now that you've got your vocals in tune, it's time to make them sound cool. So check out my other video on how to make your vocals sound gritty and cool and kind of black keys. And if you already knew this hack, comment below and let me know that I wasted your time. And of course, don't forget to click subscribe below and help me make more videos like this.